Self-improvement is masturbation. Nowadays, a lot of motivational speakers, self-help books, and social media influencers have been rising up to tell us how to achieve our best selves, which often leaves us wondering what is wrong about the current we. Unwittingly, these have been shaping us to constantly want to improve merely for the sake of improving, which does not really manifest in our lives because of the wrong kind of will that have been driving us. Instead of putting ourselves to test by engaging in challenging activities in pursuit of our goals, some of us spend more time watching other people coaching about how to be better. This phenomenon was put in simple yet controversial words by the main character of the film and novel Fight Club, Tyler Durden. According to him, self-improvement is masturbation. Was he right? The idea of self-improvement, according to former 9-year NFL starter John Welbourn, is merely a short-term gratification created because of our lack of desire to be in touch with our shortcomings. It is the constant promising that we will be better and the reason why every year we make a list of New Year's resolutions with no long-term commitment to remain true to them. Have you noticed that some self-help books are too structured and want you to lead a single path? The way to self-betterment? By giving you some simple tips that allegedly help you inch towards improvement. As if life is as simple as those, right? When we set a specific goal just because we want ourselves to feel like we have achieved something, we can never be truly happy. Just like how masturbation provides individuals an instant yet impermanent pleasure, self-improvement is a temporary illusion to feed our hungry egos. The idea that there exists such a thing as the best self and that we are nowhere near it. According to writer Nathan Adlam, the paradox of self-help is that the more self-help information you consume, the more you think you need help. In reality, you do not need help. You just have to learn how to love yourself. Going back to Tyler Durden's statement, it did not end there. He continued, self-destruction is, which leaves us wondering what he meant by that. Self-destruction is what? I'm pretty sure you're getting the idea. This fictional character is implying that allowing yourself to break free is the answer. Break free from wanting a structured and perfect life. Break free from noticing your flaws and dwelling so much on it. Break free from listening to an array of motivational speakers who push you to be better and making you feel worthless as your current self. Take note, there is nothing wrong with acknowledging that you are yet to bloom. What's wrong is thinking that quick and easy to follow solutions than actually going through the tough stages of life and learning from your own experiences. By self-destruction, Durden does not tell us to intentionally hurt ourselves. It just means that we should stop relying on wanting to be better and instead shatter our egos with the fact that yes, we are flawed, but being perfect does not happen in a snap of short-lived improvement. To live is to learn, and that's what we need to focus on. So, what are you waiting for? Ditch the impossible idea of self-improvement that has been keeping you stranded on your spot, thinking of all the things wrong about you. Rather, brace yourself and battle with this crazy little thing called real life.